Lowry is a man with a song in his heart.
I get up in the morning, sing it. It's just a part of me. Music is in me, and it's going to come out regardless of what it is.
Let's say
he said his mother first discovered his voice when he was just a kid, 5 years old, singing in church.
In high school, I was real quiet till maybe my junior year. I decided to get in a talent show. A lot of people, hey, really liked my voice, and from there, I just started singing all the time.
But these days, he's performing on much larger stages. Marcus has made a name for himself by performing the national anthem at events all across the country.
I've actually done NASCAR in Charlotte, the Charlotte Hornets, also the Oakland A's.
He sings it, and sings it well, though he admits it's not easy.
There are 13 different octaves you have to go to, and sometimes you don't hit all of them, but if you hit enough of them, you have smooth sailing through it. But it is, in the beginning, a difficult song to sing.
And the rocket ran
Marcus says he also understands the controversy and protests that have surrounded the anthem in recent years, but feels like performing the song is a calling.
I've gotten some grief over performing the song, but at the end of the day, I know God opened that door for me. He allowed that platform for me to stand on, and regardless of what a lot of people think, black or white, God wants me to do.
And he says it's still hard for him to believe that that little boy from Ramsor could grow up to do this.
Never would have imagined it at all, but God had a plan from the very beginning. Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the plan that I have for you. At 5 years old, I didn't know what that plan was, but God knew. And sometimes he had to direct my path so that he could get me to where I am right now.
And who knows where the song will take him next.
And the home of the...
Answering his calling there. Well, since the pandemic hit, he's had to record his performance and send it to a number of arenas and ballparks so it can be played.